This is a crime the city and a wailing stagnation among the people. For behold, the darkness covers the earth and gross darkness the people. But this is a people robbed and spoiled. They are all of them snared in holes and they are laid in prison houses. They are for a prey and none safe restore. Suddenly, comes a light in form of a word as a man to God's servant saying,
operating in the overflow. Say operating in the overflow. Operating in the overflow. Say it louder. Anyway, the mysteries of thanksgiving. Overflowing in the what? What did I say it? Operating in the overflow. Operating in the overflow, the mysteries of thanksgiving. How does this word work together? Remember, this is our year of what? Supernatural increase. This is our month of what? Greater joy. I reject weeping. Now, how can I reject weeping? How can I enjoy or partake of a greater joy, not only for this month, but for the rest of the year? How can I operate in the supernatural increase? Operating in the overflow. That is also mean operating in the supernatural increase. The mysteries of thanksgiving. One of the cheapest ways of actualizing greater joy that can terminate weeping is by being an addicted thanksgiver. What? Addicted thanksgiver. If you are going through any weeping, or anytime any weeping comes knocking at your door, like the one you are going through now, and the one that you will overcome today, throw yourself into the mysteries of thanksgiving. Be an addicted thanksgiver. To be honest with you, the reason you are weeping right now is because you are not an addicted thanksgiver. To be honest with you, in your situation right now, you have missed it so many times. You have missed it so long time. Why? You are not an addicted thanksgiver. Anything that is operating in your life that is giving you weeping now, I can trace it to the fact that you are not an addicted thanksgiver. The cheapest way to operate or to terminate weeping, the cheapest way to terminate weeping is by being an addicted thanksgiver. And after this word, this moment, I'm going to indoctrinate you. I'm going to baptize you by force, by fire, to engage in a dangerous thanksgiving moment. And after today's service, it will keep speaking in your life. Be what? An addicted thanksgiver. And I'm going to be opening up the mysteries of the thanksgiving. And how can I be a thanksgiver? How can I be an addicted thanksgiver? To be an addicted, me, it is already part of you. It's not just to be a casual thanksgiver. So many of you young men now, you are a casual thanksgiver. You give thanks only when it is necessary. And so when you give thanks only when it is necessary, people also give to you when it is necessary. You want to overflow in the supernatural anointing, supernatural increase, engage yourself as an addicted thanksgiver. How can I engage myself? I'm sharing with you a very deep secret. If I wish, I might not even want to read scripture. For you to be able to grab this thing, I will just paraphrase some of the scripture so that you can grab this knowledge and it will sink into your system. It will sink what? Into your medulla oblongata. If it sinks into your medulla oblongata, it will become part of your brain. Because when I look at some of you, you hear me? Or when I look at people, I shook my head. I said, I wish. And I'm going to show you the danger. I'm going to show you the benefit. I'm going to show you where you are missing it. I'm going to x-ray you now. Hearing me now. The cause of your present predicament is what you have brought to yourself. Not by what man has brought to you. It's what you have brought to yourself. Spiritually, physically. Because you are not an addicted thanksgiver. If you are not an addicted thanksgiver, you are an addicted abuser. You are not what? If you are not an addicted thanksgiver, you are an addicted abusers of men and abusers of God. And that is why God keeps his eyes away from you. That is why men keep his eyes away from you. Because you are an addicted God users. Every man, woman that are not an addicted thanksgiver, there is no two way about it. There is no I'm in between. If you are not an addicted thanksgiver, you are an addicted abuser. First Thessalonians chapter 5. First Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 1 says, but of the times and the seasons. First Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 1 and verse 18 and verse 24. But of the time and seasons. 18 says, in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Concerning you. In everything, give thanks. He started from, he said, but of the times and seasons. Not only one time. Time and season. Time and season. Of the time and season. You don't give thanks in winter and you say, in summer. You say, it is cold now. I don't have to give thanks. And then you cold yourself. Then you see everything being cold. Times and season. And I did that thanksgiver. Give thanks time and season. Not only one in season. You give thanks in season when it's only working. When it is not working, you no longer give it thanks. God say you are mumu. You are what? You are mumu. In fact, thanksgiving, the secret of thanksgiving is when things are not working. Before I forget, keep that in your mind, even if I forget that. Thanksgiving is when things are not working, not when things are working. If you are giving thanks when things are working, it doesn't make sense. You see a man that won a lotto, you say he will not give thanks. Is he stupid? But you see a man that lost lotto, he gives thanks. Then he can become the lotto winner the following day. I don't say you should go and be playing lotto. Now you say daddy is talking about lotto. So let me go and play lotto. If I find you there, I'll beat you. Beat all of you. But of the time and the season, in everything, give thanks. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because it's given Jesus Christ. Hey, be an addicted time. over. Why? Why? In verse 24 say, because faithful is he that calleth you, who also we do it. Is it not working? The marriage is not working. Give thanks. The business is not working. Give thanks to the Holy One. Why? Because faithful is he that called thee. We also will do it. You always read one scripture in verse 1 and you always ignore verse 2 or verse 20. Quaso cause Christian. Giving thanks. But all the time and season, in everything, give thanks. And somebody will not read it down to verse 24. You can imagine from verse 1 and then verse 24 say, faithful is he that called you. He will do it. He will perfect it. He's still talking about why he wanted to give him thanks. So faithful is he that called you will perfect it. And once you could not give him thanks, faithful is he who called you, who will not do it. It's as simple as that. And so people keep crying. Yes, it's like that. He said, give him thanks. And when you refuse to give him thanks, faithful is he. If you give me thanks, faithful is me that called you, I will do it. When you refuse to give me thanks, faithful is me that called you, I will leave you alone. Then weeping continue. Operating in the overflow. The mysteries of thanksgiving. So, I quickly want to show you my first scripture today again. The parable of the wilderness. The parable of the dryness. I want to show you that scripture and then I will go again and teach you and put some things into your brain. Let's look at what happened in Matthew chapter 14, verse 14. Matthew chapter 14, verse 14. The parable of the dryness increase. The parable of the dryness increase. I don't know what is dry in your life. As you are hearing me now, and as you will be part of dangerous Thanksgiver. The situation is changing in your life right now. Even from this service. I don't know whatever dryness that brought you to this service. I don't know whatever dryness that brought you to this mountain. You are going home with supernatural increase. I said you are going with supernatural increase in the name of Jesus. Let's see the mystery of thanksgiving in the dryness. The parable of the thanksgiving in supernatural increase. Verse 14, are you there? And Jesus went forth and saw a great multitude and was moved with compassion towards them. And he healed their sick. Every sickness in this house today will be healed as you are giving him thanks. Verse 15 says, as evening approached, the disciple came to him and said, this is a remote place and it's already getting late. Hear it, remote place. Number two, it's already late. Hey, listen to me. I don't know what is late in your life. As you are engaging in thanksgiving spirit today, something is breaking forth this moment. I don't know what is remote. You know what that means, remote? It's far away from what you can achieve within the next 24 hours. The God of thanksgiving will deliver you to your hand. The Bible says, and what? They were in a remote place, desert place. It was late. I don't know what people have said it is late in your life. They say marriage is late in your life. It's a lie. Say it's a lie. Say it's a lie. In fact, your own marriage has just begun today. Today. The reason why you have been delayed is because you have been delayed in giving thanks to the Lord in a new dimension. It's in a remote place. And it is already late. Not only that, it is in a desert place. Can you see all the qualifier? In a desert place, Some people are hearing me now, and they are sitting in Johannesburg, they are sitting in Limpopo, they are sitting in Alexandria, they are sitting in Soweto, they are sitting in Nigeria, and people are saying, there is dryness, there is economic crisis. Who says so? You give it, thank God. Begin to give thanks to the Lord for making you to be in that land, and the land will begin to yield of its increase. Hey, I'm liberating you today. If our Satan is in trouble, dryness is in trouble, because of this revelation. This is a remote place, and it's already getting late. Send the crowd away so that they can go to the villages and buy themselves some food. It's a lie. Remember, you know why? Anti-Thanksgiving is a lie. That man was lying to of the highest order. You know why? They were in the desert. They're going nowhere. Are you getting what I'm saying? That man is a lie. That is anti-Thanksgiving. There will be many people in your life that will give you reason to tell you that, why, what are you rejoicing for? Why are you thanking God for? You, Wena. And then you also join them. Then they begin to join you and cry with you. You are the only one crying before, now you are making two. Double crying. They're increasing your weeping. Anti-Thanksgiving agent. Jesus replied, verse 16. They do not need to go away. You give them something to eat. Verse 17. We have here only 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. They answer, bring them here to me. Verse 18, Jesus said, and he directed the people to sit down on the grass, taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fishes, and looking up to heaven, he gave thanks. Looking down to heaven, he gave thanks and broke the loaves. Then he gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the people. They all ate and were satisfied, and the disciples picked up 12 baskets of broken pieces that were left over. The number of those who ate are about 5,000 men, beside women and children. And you also know that in any crusade, women are more plenty. Now, this is the mystery. Before I put this thing into your brain, and I've always said it, and I will keep reminding you, if they were in a desert and somebody said, let's send them away, where are they going to? In the desert. We are actually, right now, this is the orders of this scripture. We are in the world of desert today now. We are in a desert world. Where everything is not certain anymore now. America is supposed to be the leader of the world. They are even now engineering crisis, economic crisis, right now. You know what I'm talking about. So, Mama Remu was teaching us, in this economic holocaust or whatever, in this economic crisis, global economic crisis, the only thing that can salvage men and women, me and you, Christian, is to lean on God. And our leaning on God is by thanksgiving. Because it produces the supernatural. It produces the supernatural. Beside the mysteries of tithe and giving, tithe, seed, tithe and offering, beside the mystery of tithe and offering, the another mystery that the world will not recover and will never finish preaching is the mystery of thanksgiving. Because it is the mystery that produces supernatural increase from heaven. Why? God could not praise himself. God does not know how to praise himself. God does not know how to thank himself. He leaned on men to thank him. That is why he even instituted the 24 elders to be praising him. And as those 24 elders are praising him, his color is changing every second. Every second, as 24 elders are changing, are praising him, if the color of the Lord is changing every second. The Bible made us know the color of the Lord is changing. So if he changes color to you that is thanking him, what is blue become white. He changes his color. And things begin to produce of his own self. Supernatural increase. The mysteries of thanksgiving. And I said to you, from the 5 loaves and 2 fishes, He gives thanks. Father, I know I'm in the wilderness. Hey, it's a dangerous faith. There is no thanksgiving without faith. He said, for he himself knows what to do. But the man of a little faith, he said, let's send them away. Because there is nothing that can happen here in the dryness. Can I ask you a question? If they were sent away, he himself would be sent away. Do you know what I'm saying? He himself will be sent away. Otherwise, he will die of hunger in that dryness. So, in dryness, the only thing that can deliver you and me is thanksgiving. And I don't want to take too much. You know that story. And when he gives thanks, the miracle that we have never seen began to happen. He put two bread in his hand. And as they are giving it, it's increasing. As they are giving it, it's increasing. We didn't see how it is increasing. We didn't see it dropping from heaven. We just saw it increasing. As they are. That's what is called supernatural increase. Nobody knew how those bread and fishes were increasing. We just saw it. We know about manners. Are you getting what I'm saying? We know about manners. Manna was dropping and everybody was seeing it. But in this one, it was not dropping. But it kept increasing. It's like you keep 5 rand in your pocket. And when you took that 5 rand to the Lord and said thank you, you put your hands back again in the pocket, you find another 50 rand. You took that 50 rand, you took it, you put it to the offering, you put your hands again, you find 1,000. You are not wondering, what is happening? Is it a magic? Is it a miracle? Why? Thanksgiving. That's why every month, every end of the month, when we say Thanksgiving service, you look at it casually. Some of you just even come and say, this is the end of the month. I will show you a mystery right now. Activating, operating in the overflow, the mysteries of thanksgiving. La Rocha Catali Alaba. So it keeps increasing. Only for him when he say, Father, thank you. Now quickly, I want to show you. Remember that man that said, let's send them away. I will show you what is in the mind of that man. But before that, I want to show you what was in the mind of Jesus Christ. There are two personalities here. Are you getting me? In fact, there are three personalities. Jesus Christ, the boy that had that bread, the man that said, let us stay down the way. Are you getting me? Three personalities. I will show you three of them now. Firstly, let me show you. What are the blessings or advantage of thanksgiving? When Jesus said, Father, thank you. I know this is little, but you can increase it. What are the advantages of thanksgiving? Number one. Advantage of thanksgiving. Thanksgiving is a water of our mouth that wet our destiny. Thanksgiving what? Is the water of our mouth. The water of our mouth. That what? That wet or that nourish our destiny. Likewise, when a man planted a corn and it turned out to be a maize, there is a water, there is rain that water gardens. Are you getting what I'm saying? People of God, get what I'm saying now? When you plant a seed, you water it, yes or no, for it to grow. That is when you are putting your labor into it. The same way, when a man says thanks, when a man is a man of thanksgiving, it is your wet. It is like when you are releasing the wetness of your mouth. You know, our mouth is full of what? Saliva is a form of water. So when a man is saying, Father, thank you. Father, thank you. Every time you are saying thank you, watch it. And I want you to say it now. There is some kind of secret. There is a sound of flu that came from your mouth. All of you say it. Say, Father, thank you. Say it again. Say it again. Say it again. Say it again. By the time you say it 12 times, you have accumulated enough of saliva in your mouth. That saliva is what grease your destiny in the spiritual realm. It's like a water that you are releasing into what? Into your destiny. Let me give you another one. Do like this. Do it very well. By the time you do it 20 times, your mouth are dry. Continue doing it and tell me how you feel. What are you? In fact, when you put it without nonsense. Nonsense. What has he done? What has he done? The more you are saying it, the more you won't even have saliva to talk anymore. Everything is dry. So that's why every time you are not a thanksgiver, your destiny is getting dry. Hello? Am I saying something to you? It's like a water that water our destiny. Just as the rain wet the garden for increase. Number two, it's our physical and spiritual thermometer that measures our faith. Advantage of thanksgiving, it's a physical and spiritual thermometer. That is how I can measure your spiritual faith when you are saying, anybody that say thanksgiving, that is saying thank you. At this level, I want you to tell you that there are two types of thanksgiving. The thanksgiving before, the thanksgiving after. So it makes me, when I see you as a man or a woman of thanksgiving, to be able to measure your faith level. Number three, thanksgiving is a token of agreement between man and God, which automatically confirm our expectation to manifestation in all things, giving thanks. For God is faithful is he that called thee, and that he that will do it. He said it in his word, giving thanks. Faithful is he that called you, who will perfect it. Because so it is an agreement between, it's a token of agreement. The moment you say, Father, thank you for everything, you are giving him what? You are releasing the token of agreement between you and him to do what he has not done. Number four, it is a seed of humility. Thanksgiving is a seed of humility and surrenderness to the God of all possibilities. Humility and surrenderness to God of all possibility. Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving shows your humility. Thanksgiving what? Shows your humility to say, Father, I humble myself before you, for you are the doer of all these things. The moment you could not give thanks, it's showing your arrogancy. I will soon show you there. The moment you don't know how to give thanks, you are telling God that after all, I'm a PhD holder in economics, I'm a PhD holder in, so I want it. Oh. But everyone that gives thanksgiving, when a professor, when a businessman gives thanks, you are telling the Lord, it is not my money that has done this. It is you. You are showing your humility. It's a seed of what? Humility. And before I forget, if I give you something, or if you give me something, no matter how small it is, if I truly appreciate it, I will say thank you. So So it is a sign of my humility to him. If I give him and he said thank you, it's a sign of what? Humility. And it's a sign of appreciation. And fifth one, it's a secret to activating supernatural increase. When you say thank you, it's an activation of supernatural increase. When Jesus said, Father, thank you, the fruit, the bread, the fish began to increase. Now, quickly, I'll show you types of thanksgiving. The types of thanksgiving. We have spiritual thanksgiving. We have physical thanksgiving. We have what? Spiritual thanksgiving and then physical thanksgiving. I will quickly look at it for you. Spiritual thanksgiving is spiritually between you and God. You wake up in the morning, thank you. It's a spiritual thing. Spiritual thanksgiving is between you and God. Physical thanksgiving is between you and men. And two of them works together. No one override the others. Spiritual thanksgiving, physical thanksgiving. How do I operate in the spiritual thanksgiving? You operate in spiritual thanksgiving via substances. Substances. You operate in physical thanksgiving by the lips of your mouth. The seed of your mouth. That is your lips of praise. You give him praise. You give him praise. That is one of the ways to activate spiritual thanksgiving. Another way to activate spiritual thanksgiving is in substances. And there are so many ways of substances. Number one is your tithe and offering. Your seed. Financial seed. Physical seed. You can come to the Lord in thanksgiving only by saying, Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you. Yes. Father, after you say, Father, I thank you, God is now looking at you. What next? To say, Father, I don't have so much, but out of what you have given me, this is what I'm giving you. There is nobody, even baby, that does not have substance to give. Do you know why? Even on the naming of the baby, a baby has a gift. He must take something to the Lord in thanksgiving. How much more adult? You are saying thanksgiving. I will praise you now for the yes, thank you. God still expecting you to show something from your pocket to show that you appreciate, no matter how little it is. Even if you have turned around a gift since the beginning of this month, can somebody tell me that nobody has given you 50 rand a gift since the beginning of the month? God requires 5 rand and 1 rand after your tithe and 1 rand or 50 cents to say, Father, thank you. That is how to show the Lord in substance giving. Type of spiritual thanksgiving. You show thanksgiving in consistencies, spiritual demonstration. I was speaking to one of my daughters yesterday. I said, where is brother so-so-so? That brother, we used to give him 50 rand, 100 rand last year, December, we remember very well. We used to give him 50 rand, 200 rand to go back to town. My daughter, that's one I'm talking about, used to give this brother food. She would do shopping and give him food. She would do give her money and everything like that. And the brother came to me suddenly. He said, Father, God has blessed me. I said, Hallelujah. I even shout my Hallelujah. It's even more than him. He said, this is my fourth car. I'm buying and sending. Blah, 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 blah. But after that time, I said, oh boy, where is your tithe and your offering in the house of the Lord? For he has forgotten the time he was suffering in the house of the Lord. Ask yourself, what do you think? If he's not doing it in Wami, I pray that you will be doing it in Tami or in another place. But if you cannot even do it where God bless you, there is no assurance that you will do it in another place. There is no assurance. Those that are not addicted thanksgiver, they are addicted God user. If you are in that category, change. How can you bless the Lord back? And part of spiritual thanksgiving is being consistent in the house of the Lord. Even if you don't have the money, but your consistency in his altar is giving God joy that he has kept your life. You get what I'm saying? For God keeping your life and you being in church every Wednesday, every Saturday, every Sunday is to say, Lord, I give you time for keeping my life. God is mindful of it even when you don't have money. But you are appreciating him for the gift of life. So, God is committed to make sure that that sickness die completely in your body. Because you are giving him thanks with your presence. With your presence. Many times your presence in the house of the Lord is his present. Or your present. Your presence in the house of the Lord is his own present. Is you are giving him a gift. For appearing him in the house of the Lord. You are giving him what? A gift. So many times when you come to church, you think you are coming to church for me. No, you are coming to the Lord yourself to present yourself unto the Lord. Father, I thank you for giving me life. Even if it's not working now, I know it's going to work by next Sunday. By next Sunday, you are coming again. Father, I still thank you that I'm still alive. I'm not in the hospital. I'm not in prison. God will help you. If you find yourself in prison, in the police station, what? In fact, you will keep saying, Father, please, if you release me from this prison, I'll be thanking you. But as soon as so many people are released from the prison, they forget God. And then Satan will take them back. See, because you are ungrateful. Spiritual thanksgiving. So also is physical thanksgiving. They also go in the same way. Be consistent to somebody that has blessed you. Show appreciation to somebody that has blessed you. Somebody has blessed you, has given you life physically. Physically, I'm talking about now physically. Somebody has called you and said, what are you doing now? I'm doing nothing. He said, no. Come to my office and I'll give you a job. And then he gave you a job. Ah. Be consistent to him or to her. Boss, thank you. I really enjoy this job. Thank you. You are making him crazy to think of the next position he will put you. But after giving you the job, you have become the manager. You bought your first car. Now you and that boss, you are now paddy, no longer thank you. He will soon look for a way to take that job from you and give to another person that knows how to evaluate it. Thank you physically to your neighbor, to your employer. Thank you physically to your pastor. It doesn't cost you anything. All of you here, I have not owed you one penny this year to say thank you. I know how much I've given my own spiritual father this year to say thank you. That's how it works. That's how it works. Physically. If a man give me a shoe, even if the shoe is not my size, I will wear it first day. I will wear it. I will what? If he give me a shoe and it's not my size, I will wear it. By the time I wear it and I'm doing like this, he will know that it's not my size. He will come back to me and say, Father, I think that shoe is not your size. I'll bring another one. I say, yes, correct. Correct. Many a time, some of my sons here, when they gave me shirt, the shirt I'm wearing now, look at it. One of you gave me. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma. I'm saying it again. Maybe I forgot to say it. Thank you, sir. So every time I wear it, I come to him. I say, oh, boy. You see? And then he smiles. So another time, he brought me another 5. He brought me another shoe. I say, yeah, oh, boy. You see? That's your shoe. That's what? Appreciating him physically. Hello? So if you have not yet brought your home, I'm waiting. If you have not yet what? Brought your home, I'm waiting. You want to know my size? Ask Mama Tau. He will tell you my size. What about your friends that are seated next to you? How many times have you said, sister, brother, thank you? How many times have you said, even for sitting next to you, He's doing you a favor. She's doing you a favor. See, for sitting next to you. How many times, husband and wife, have you said, oh, okay, I know I'm the worst husband, but thank you for marrying me. That's why you say my husband is not good. That's why he's slapping you every day. Because you don't know how to say thank you to him. So the best thing you deserve is to slap you. Yo. So if you want to slap it to stop, keep saying to your husband every morning, baby, thank you for marrying me. Hey! You will see that night you won't get a dirty slap. Hallelujah! Quickly, let me rush down to the enemy of thanksgiving. Like that man that said to Jesus, Jesus, these people, they can't find anything. These are the things that is running in his own mind. Number one, enemy of thanksgiving, ungratefulness. Say it. On what? Ungratefulness. Every time you are ungrateful, people, men are ungrateful. And they will always be ungrateful till Jesus comes. Unless if you are hearing my word now and you are changing. Say, I'm changing. Tell your neighbor, I am changing from today, from being ungrateful to be grateful. So many people, men to men to God, we are ungrateful. We quickly forgotten what happened last year. We quickly forgotten what happened 20 years back. We quickly forgotten when we were born. As a body, as a good, handsome man, good, beautiful woman, you quickly forgot it, that you are born beautifully, handsomely. But now, you are blaming God. Because you are blaming God, that's why you are in the same situation. But be grateful to the Lord every day, every time. Please, remember, foreigners or South Africa, remember the day you got your ID. What did you say? You said, Father, thank you. Hey, finally, I got my ID. So if the ID is not working now, have you forgotten the day you collected it when you say thank you? Keep saying thank you to the Lord. When now you are hearing me now, you forgot it the day you got a visa to this nation. And now you are saying, hey, what is happening in this nation? Say, this nation is not going to... God is slapping your mouth for washing your mouth like that. Because you remember the day he gave you that visa. You said thank you. But now you are saying... That's why you remain complaining. Ungratefulness. Ungratefulness. Sons and parents. When you are ungrateful to your parents will be what? Will be nasty to you also. If you don't know how to say thank you, mommy. Listen to me, all sons and daughters hearing me. Every month your parents pay your school fees. You must go to them and say, mommy, daddy, thank you for my school fees. Otherwise, you are an ungrateful sons and daughters to them. You are making them to feel like they are wasting their money on you. Employee, you are hearing me now. Every month, your employer gives you salary. Go to him or go to her. Boss, thank you for my salary. Thank you for my salary. I used to have a staff. After Titi, how to give thanks. And she refused to be thankful upon that small thing. She said, I stop her. I said, you know what? You have been ungrateful. So please don't be on your own also. If you are ungrateful, not only man, even God, stop being grateful to you also. If you are ungrateful to your wife or to your husband, he or she stop being grateful to you also. He withdraw all his personalities. Enemy of thanksgiving, your ungratefulness. Say my ungratefulness. Say I'm changing from today. Another enemy of thanksgiving is people around you. People around you can make you to say, after all, what is it now? Please, ignore the people around you, making you to be ungrateful. Don't mind what people around you are saying about you or are saying about other people. That man, he's a stingy man. That man, but is he stingy to you? They will discourage you. People around you will discourage you to be ungrateful to people. Please, put them aside and be grateful. Number three, your mentality. Your mentality will make you to be ungrateful. Why? Because you have calculated everything and say, it's my doing. Or you are saying, it's not working. You have made yourself worthless. Or you have made situation worthless and you feel, your mentality. Number four, your egoism. Your what? Egoism. Your egoism. That is your arrogancy. Can make you never to be thankful to anybody. Arrogancy. Now, because you are the richest person in Wami, you thought that you have arrived. You are too big to say thank you, even to the usher. And usher just bring you in now, and with your pomposity, you just say, please leave me down. Usher collected the Bible. Find your Bible or your cell phone and bring it to you. Say, excuse me, sir. I saw your cell phone on the table. Oh, okay. Mr. Too Big. Mr. Too Big. When that usher find that cell phone again, he will not give it to you. He will take it and God will not blame him. Because when you are ungrateful. Big manism. Big manism. Oh, the big manism. CEO. You don't know how to say thank you to your manager. CEO, you don't even know how to say thank you to the gate man. A gate man, please drop your egoism anywhere, not only in church. Drop that your arrogancy today and embrace appreciation spirit, thanksgiving spirit. It doesn't kill. It doesn't kill. To say thank you does not kill. But when you are a man and a woman that is full of arrogancy, it's a difficult word for you. It's too word, thank you. But the moment you are a big man for God, that thank you is a very million word in your mouth to say. And it will do so many benefits from your life. Hallelujah. Is somebody hearing me this morning? Your egoism. Your egoism. Your egoism. How to overcome enemy of thanksgiving? How to overcome enemy of thanksgiving? Number one, repentance. Absolute repentance. It's not too late for you to drop your arrogancy spirit. It's not too late for you to repent of not giving thanks in substance, in offering, in praise. It's not too late. Start it now. Say, start it now. Tell your neighbor, start it now. So as you are talking to your neighbor, no, say, neighbor, thank you. See, it's never too late. Repentance. It's not how far you have gone in being ungrateful. It's how far or how quick you can repent from it now. And you are doing it today also. Never postpone thanksgiving. Never postpone thanksgiving. Never postpone thanksgiving. Enemy of thanksgiving. How I can overcome enemy of thanksgiving. Never postpone thanksgiving. I will give him thanks when I get the job. I will thank him when I get married. You are postponing it. That's the reason why you may not get married. Are you getting what I'm saying? Never postpone thanksgiving. Number four of it, be contented with what you have now. Only when you are content with what you have, that's when you can give thanks. So many of you are, your salary is 500. And that's why you felt, what am I giving thanks for? Or your employer is paying you 1,005 and you are not contented with it. That arrogancy will never allow you to say thank you to your boss. Because in your mind, you have said 1,005. My mate, my colleague, I earned 5,000. Me, I'm earning 1,005. And we are doing the same job. Be what? Content. If you fail to contend with what you have, thanksgiving will be difficult in your mouth. And the moment you could not say thanksgiving, there is no increase. be what? Be contented with what you have. That's how you can overcome the enemy of thanksgiving. Finally, what are the advantages? What are the disadvantages of non-thanksgiver? The danger of not being a thanksgiver. The dangers. The dangers. The bottom line of all this is I'm talking about what are the dangers of not being a thanksgiver. If you are not an addicted thanksgiver, what are the dangers? It's very dangerous not to be a thanksgiver, not to be an addicted thanksgiver. You don't appreciate people. You don't give thanks to the Lord. You don't appreciate one another. That is very dangerous. Very, very what? Dangerous. And number one of it is that if you are not a thanksgiver person, you end up losing everything. You end up losing everything spiritually, physically. God end up ignoring you, and then you end up losing everything. Men ignore you, and you end up losing everything because you don't know how to give God or men thanks. Okay, I gave you a rich watch, and you look at it. This rich watch, is this the rich watch your men, other men are giving to their girlfriend? Is this the kind of rich watch other husbands are giving to their wives? I will wait for the day that rich watch will fall down, and I will pick it and I will throw it away, because you hurted my feeling the day you said that way to me. Likewise, God, He will wait for when you will finish that thing He gave you, or God Himself will corrupt it. And then weeping continue. Since you don't know how to say thank you, you may end up losing everything. Say God forbid. Say God forbid. It's not a prayer, it's an action. It's an action. You may end up losing everything. You may not get anything anymore. You may be in one spot till Jesus come, and you may be rotting in it. Also, number two, you become a mockery. Dangers of not being a thanksgiving. You become a mockery. Everybody is just mocking you because of your non-being thanksgiver. They are mocking you. Say, your friend. Or when I see you coming to my office, or when that man see you coming to his or her house, he or she is laughing at you. See, your friend has come again to ask for the money. The one I gave in yesterday, did she even say thank you? No, even come on SMS. No, even come on, thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. And now you are coming again. You are a mockery. They will mock you. They will mock you. The same way, you are not a thanksgiver to God. God will mock you. In the day of your calamity, God will mock. Say, God forbid. It's not a word. It's an action. I rest my case. I rest my case. And finally, every ungrateful person, every non-thanksgiver, they are ungrateful. And they find themselves in the grave. They what? They find themselves in the grave. It is a matter of time. Every ungrateful element, they find themselves in the grave. Because you thought it's your power and your ability, or you thought it's your beauty that made me to give you that thing. No! You will soon find yourself in the grave when next you need help, and that help did not come. Pastor, I've heard you. How can I repent? How can I repent? Every one of you need to repent of being ungrateful to the Lord and to your person. But I'm going to talk about unto the Lord, because if you can be grateful to the Lord, you will be able to be grateful unto men. If you are ungrateful to God, you can never be grateful to men. That's not the truth. You know why? The God that you didn't see, you cannot be grateful to Him. Even the men that you see, they will be naughty to you. So this morning, we are going to the altars of
praise the Lord with all your energy. Jesus. Only this middle one.
Praise Jesus.
Just this middle one. Just carry this middle one, and then people will have space. Hallelujah. You want to tell the Lord that, Lord, whatever that is not working, whatever that is not working in my life, what are you saying now, Pastor D? So do the left side.
Jesus.
Do the left side quickly. I want you to have space. Altar, anywhere. Please do what? A Holy Ghost dance to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let God see how Hallelujah. Desperate you are by this prayer, by this section. Let God see how desperate you are by this section. Holy Ghost dance is a smart thanksgiving Praise. Section unto the Lord. I will be on my own, you will do on your own. Are you ready?
Two.
Are you ready?
Hallelujah.
Are you ready? Shake your body. Say, today, I am here for God.
Praise.
Hallelujah.
Lord, you are so good. Blessed be your name. Lord, you are so good. Blessed be your name. In heavens, you are the Lord. Our age, you reign forever. Oh Lord, our great hour. Oh, blessed be your name. Lord, you are so good.
You are so good.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be your name.
Lord, you are so good.
Lord, you are so good.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be your name.
In heaven, you are the Lord.
In heaven, you are the Lord.
On earth, you reign
forever.
Oh Lord, my God.
Oh Lord, our great
hour. Blessed be your name.
Come on, put your hands together. One, two, come on, let me hear you. Your hands, come on, come on, come on.
Whoa, in heaven you are the Lord.
In heaven you are the Lord.
On earth you reign it forever. Oh Lord, my God.
Oh Lord, our great
Lord. Blessed be your name. God is able to do just what he said he will do.
Hey!
He's gonna fulfill every promise to you.
Hey!
Don't give up on God, cause he will give up on
you. Let me hear you say, he's able. Hallelujah!
Oh, he's able.
Let me say, let me hear you say,
hallelujah.
He's
able.
Somebody make a joy.
Hey.
Let me hear. Hallelujah.
He's able.
He's
able.
He's
able.
He's
able.
He's
able.
He's
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Come on. Jehovah Jireh, omnipotent God. Hey, omniscience God. Mighty man in battle. Shut up.
Let's bring it on. Bring it on. Hello.
Jesus.
Now tell your neighbor, praise your way into your miracle. Tell somebody, praise your way into your miracle. Now shake that person. Hey. Shake that person. Hey, hey. Shake that person. Hey, 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 hey. Are you ready? Are you ready? Celebrate. Can I see you? Now watch me. Hello? Are you ready to dance this morning? Now hear this. As you are dancing, God is healing you now. You did not hear what I said. As you are dancing, anything that is not of God is leaving your body now. Are you ready? Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Shake it up. 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 Shake it up.
No. Wait. Now, I want to teach you one dance this morning. Are you ready? If you go to Nigeria, that is what we call keke na pepe. Ah, yeah, yeah. James, come. I want to show them one dance this morning. Are you ready? If you want to let this one come and join us this live, if you want to dance with us, if you want to dance with us, you know, keke na pepe, this is how they dance here.
Jesus.
Now, we do it 3 times. You begin to move. As you're moving, your miracles are moving. You did not hear me. As you're moving, your new cars is moving.
Jesus.
Hey! Are you ready? Now, 3 times, so let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's go. Hey! Hey! More time. Hello. As you are doing it, your new car is coming.
Jesus.
As you are doing it, you are receiving your healing now.
Jesus.
The Bible said in the presence of God there is fullness of joy. This is your Father's house. Now shake your body. Shake your body. Shout, yay! Shout, yay, 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 yay! Are you ready? Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's go. Hey! 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 Now let me ask you.
My God is a good God.
Yes, he is. I did not hear you. I did not hear your voice. Your God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
Are you ready? Now demonstrate.
He lifts me up.
He lifts me up.
Is taking someone to a next level. Let me see. He lifts me up.
He lifts me up.
Hallelujah. Let me see. He does me around.
He touches me around.
Say your neighbor. Everything is turning around for your good. Hey. He does me around.
He touches me around.
Hallelujah.
Set my feet.
One leg up. Hey, one leg up. Let me see. I feel like shouting.
I feel excited.
Hey, I did not hear you. Let go. I feel like jumping.
I feel like jumping.
Hey, hey, hey! happy.
Feel like happy.
Your hands, your hands. This one. Come on, come on, come on. Your hands, your hands. Come on. As you're clapping your hands, you are destroying the hands of your enemies. Your hands. Come on, 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 come on. Here we go, here we go.
Cast your body unto Jesus, for he cares.
Let me see.
Cast your body unto Jesus, for he cares.
Lift Jesus higher,
higher, higher.
Hey.
Jesus, higher.
Can I see?
Yeah.
Jesus,
higher.
Hey. Hallelujah.
Jesus,
higher. Hey. Now let me see.
Satan lower. Satan lower. Satan lower. Satan lower.
Can you lower Satan? At the mention of that name, Jesus, every knee shall bow. Lower Satan, lower Satan, lower Satan. Are you ready? Lay Jesus higher.
Higher, higher,
hey. Hallelujah. Lay Jesus higher.
Higher,
hey. Hallelujah. Come on,
Jesus.
Lay Jesus higher.
Higher,
hey.
Wait, wait, wait.
Come on, bring it up. I can see that many of you are struggling this morning. Hello. Hello. Now, I want you to pose this way as if you are carrying a gun tonight. Now, carry your gun. Carry your gun. Anything that has been blocking your miracles, after this morning, they will give away for you. Bring it up small. Hello. Anything that has been pursuing you, after this praise this morning, you will begin to pursue them. I don't like that amen. Can I hear a better amen? Why are they not shouting amen, Papa? Hey! Shout amen,
Jesus.
Are you ready? Now we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hello. You know it. You know it. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Are you ready? Are you ready? Now pose very well. Ask your neighbor, give me space. Tell your neighbor to give you some space. Neighbor, give me space. Oh. Are you ready? Now carry your machine gun. Carry your gun very well. Are you ready? Are you ready? You are going to shoot sickness, poverty, disease, untimely death, stagnation. Are you ready to destroy them now? 1, 2, 3, 4. Can we do it one more time? Can we do it one more time?
Yes.
Can we do it one more time? Can we do it one more time? Hey! Let's go. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let me see. Kimbale Luton de Columba lo said that.
Sabi wa moyo.
Give your neighbor.
Sabi wa moyo. Sabi wa moyo.
Come on.
Sabi wa moyo. Sabi wa moyo.
Come on.
Sabi wa moyo. Sabi wa moyo.
Sabi wa moyo. Sabi wa moyo. Come on.
Sabi wa moyo. Sabi wa moyo.
Hey.
Sabi wa moyo. Sabi wa moyo.
Hey. 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 Hey.
1, 2.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Hey. Hey. Let me see you. Holy Ghost dance. Hey. Let me see. me like that? Why are you looking at me? Come on. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey, hey, my God is good. Oh.
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 Hello. Wait, wait, wait. Bring it down. I don't like the way you are dancing. Come, follow me. Follow me. Woza, 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 woza. Woza, 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 woza. Woza, come and be here. Why are you at the back? And the children are there. You know this song? 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey! Hey! Wait, wait. Where are you from? You are from Zimbabwe. Okay. You're gonna dance in Zimbabwe style now, okay? We want to see it now. How many Zimbabweans are here? Oh yeah, come here. Come. Come. Let's take this place to Zimbabwe. Let's take this place to Zimbabwe. You know that song now? You know that dancing? You know that one? You know that one? Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Come on. Now wait, wait. Now where are South Africans? South Africans, come and show us. Achina, China. Aibo. Waza, 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 waza. Are you ready? Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's go. Come on now. Celebrate, 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 celebrate. 1, 2, 3. Now we are going into Holy Ghost dance.
Yes.
Umu Jehovah, every mina go. Come on, come on. Let me hear. Umu Jehovah, every mina. Hey, umu. Hey, hey. Ake, ukava. Umu Jehovah, every mina go.
Hey,
every Hallelujah, amen.
Hallelujah.
Hey.
Hallelujah.
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 Hey.
Hallelujah.
Again. Hey. 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 Come on. Come on. Baleka. 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 Hallelujah. Come. Hallelujah. Somebody. Come on. Baleka. Come on. Come on.
Baleka.
Waza, 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 waza. Come. Hey, 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 hey. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Hallelujah. Wherever you are, where you are standing, just lift up your hands and say, Holy Ghost, do it again in my life. Holy Ghost, I'm giving you thanks. I'm giving you thanks. Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Holy Ghost.
Holy Spirit, move me now.
Just give him praise.
And make my life all again.
Just give him worship.
Spirit move, over me.
Holy Spirit.
Spirit move.
Lord, we give him praise.
Over me.
Lord, we give your praise this
morning. Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Wow.
Moving
man. I make my life whole again.
I make my life whole again.
Spirit move.
Spirit move.
Whoa.
Over me.
Spirit move.
Spirit move.
Just say in your mind and your word, say, Father, thank you.
Father,
say it louder.
Father,
say it louder.
Father.
I want us to say it 12 times. How many times? And at the end of the 12 times, we leave it to God. Leave your life, leave your situation, leave the crisis, everything. Unto the Holy Ghost. Are you ready? One, two, go. One, Father. Say it louder. One,
Father,
two,
Father,
three,
Father,
four,
Father,
five, level.
Father,
wait.
Thank you.
We have done the 11. Now we are going to the 12. You know that 12 is to say, Father, I know by December I will be saying thank you. So after that 12, just what the Holy Spirit will do. Worship team, after the 12, 2 minutes, let the Holy Spirit just take over. Instrumentalist, I need you at that time. Are you ready? Are you ready? Say, Father, thank you with all your might. Father,
thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
It is done. Say it is done. Say it louder. Say it louder. Go home with the blessings of the Lord. Go home with supernatural increase. Whatever that is not enough in your life, go home with supernatural increase. It is done. It is done. Tell your neighbor with handshake. It is. It is. It is.